أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويوم يحشرهم وما يعبدون من دون الله فيقول أأنتم أضللتم عبادي هؤلاء أم هم ضلوا السبيل؟ قالوا سبحانك ما كان ينبغي لنا أن نتخذ من دونك من أولياء ولكن متعتهم وآباءهم حتى نسوا الذكر وكانوا قوما بورا فقد كذبوكم بما تقولون فما تستطيعون صرفا ولا نصرا ومن يظلم منكم نذقه عذابا كبيرا وما أرسلنا قبلك من المرسلين إلا إنهم ليأكلون الطعام ويمشون في الأسواق وجعلنا بعضكم لبعض فتنة أتصبرون وكان ربك بصيرا. صدق الله العظيم. In the previous ayat of this surah, Surah Al-Furqan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about His oneness and greatness, and the prophethood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered some of the questions that kuffar were raising about the prophethood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned the kuffar of the fire of Jahannam and gave very brief description of Jahannam. And of course, as the description of Jahannam came, so to compare that with the other side, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a short description of Jannah. After all of that, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding everyone that this life is not a place where the decision would be really made. The main decisions would be made in Akhirah. And whatever we do in this life, we need to keep in mind that all of this will have to be presented on the Day of Judgment before Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah will judge us. And this is why one of the ayahs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that the main problem is that they deny the Akhirah. That is their main problem. The problem is not that they have all of these objections about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's only they say whatever they feel like saying. Whatever comes to a person's mouth, he just wants to say. He wants to say something. Why? Because he feels he can just say it and be done with it. They don't realize that each and every word they say, they will be judged for it in Akhirah and the hereafter. So therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now is reminding the kuffar that what would happen to you in Akhirah? Can you think about that? وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. The day when He will gather all of them and what they used to worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will gather all of you and everything that you worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even their idols will be up on that day. They will be able to see their idols. And as other ayahs of the Quran tell us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would even throw those idols in Jahannam as a fuel of Jahannam. But with that, they also worship some living beings. They worship Malaika. They worship Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, which is also shirk. And there were groups from Bani Israel who worshipped Uzair alayhi salatu wa salam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, وقالت اليهود عزير ابن الله. They said Uzair was the son of Allah والعياذ بالله. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will resurrect them and all of those that they have worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَقُولُ فَأَنْتُمْ أَضْلَلْتُمْ عِبَادِي هَؤُلَاءِ أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّ السَّبِيلِ. Then Allah will ask them, did you mislead my servants or they themselves lost the way? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, will ask Malaika, he will ask Uzair alayhi salam, all the people that were worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they claim that they want us to worship them and they connect us to Allah. They are our God. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask these ones that they consider to be God beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their presence, in the presence of the ones who worship them, أَأَنْتُمْ أَضْلَلْتُمْ عِبَادِي هَؤُلَاء. Did you mislead all of my servants? أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّ السَّبِيلِ. Or they themselves lost the way. So they will reply, قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ مَا كَانَ يَنْبَغِي لَنَا أَن نَتَّقِذَ مِن دُونِكَ مِنْ أَوْلِيَاءَ. They will say, glory be to you, Ya Allah. It was not for us to take protectors beside you. مَا كَانَ يَنْبَغِي لَنَا. It wasn't for us. It wasn't possible for us. We could never do anything like this. أَنَّ تَقِذَ مِن دُونِكَ مِن أَوْلِيَا. That we choose protectors beside you. Look at the answer now. You may not have paid attention to the answer. If you look at the answer, really is not answering the question. What is the question? أَأَنْتُمْ أَضْلَلْتُمْ عِبَادِي هَؤُلَاء أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّ السَّبِيلِ. Did you mislead them or they lost the way? And they're saying, it wasn't possible for us to choose protectors beside you. So where is the answer? And this is what we need to understand, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a beautiful way is explaining to us. That their response is telling us that, Ya Allah, not to talk about telling them to worship anything besides you. We never even chose helpers beside you. Forget about us worshipping anything else beside you. And if we didn't worship anything else, we worshipped you, how could we tell them to worship anything else beside you? So, what a beautiful way of explaining that, Ya Allah, I never even got close to it. I never even thought about it. For sure, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam never thought that he would want people to worship him or people would worship him. He doesn't want that. Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, they don't want anything like that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says very clearly in Quran al-Kareem, مَا كَانَ لِنَبِيٍّ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُ اللَّهُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَ وَالنُّبُوَّةِ. مَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ. It's not possible for any human being that he receives the book from Allah and he receives the hikmah and the wisdom from Allah, wahy, and he receives the nabuwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ يَقُولَ لِلنَّاسِ كُونُوا عِبَادًا لِي مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Then he would tell people that worship me beside Allah. In fact, what he tells people, وَلَكِنْ كُونُوا رَبَّانِيِّينَ. Subhanallah. This is what Anbiya say to people, that be the people of Rabb. Be رَبَّانِيِّينَ. And رَبَّانِيِّينَ means the people who of Rabb. Which means in everything, your connection is to your Rabb. This is what Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam were doing. They were connecting human beings to the Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُونُوا رَبَّانِيِّينَ. So, the ones that were worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they never even thought about it, they didn't want it. In fact, They hate it. They know this is shirk. They know this is kufr. They came to present Iman and Islam, not shirk and kufr. They came to fight shirk. And people are using them for shirk. Of course, this is when you are opposing a person's mission and then you try to put him against his own mission. So, the response of Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam of Malaika would be, مَا كَانَ يَنْبَغِي سُبْحَانَكَ Glory to you, Ya Allah. مَا كَانَ يَنْبَغِي لَنَا أَن نَتَّخِذَ مِنْ دُونِكَ مِنْ أَوْلِيَا It wasn't possible for us that we would choose even helpers beside you. Forget about us worshipping anything else beside you and then telling people to worship anything else beside you. That's not possible. وَلَكِنْ But what happened? What was the reality? Now since they have mentioned that we were not the reason. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them, أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّ السَّبِيلِ Did they lost the way themselves? So now they are responding to that portion. وَلَكِنْ مَتَّعْتَهُمْ وَآبَاءَهُمْ حَتَّى نَسُوا الذِّكْرَ وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا بُورًا But you let them and their forefathers enjoy the comfort of the worldly life until they forgot the reminder. So what happened? They lost the way, Ya Allah. We didn't tell them anything like this. In fact, we gave them the right teaching. And through our teaching, they were able to worship you, Ya Allah. But what happened was, when they kept on getting the beauty of the world and the luxuries of the world, and you kept on giving them and giving them and giving them, مَتَّعْتَهُمْ وَآبَاءَهُمْ Look at the words of Anbiya. مَتَّعْتَهُمْ وَآبَاءَهُمْ You kept on giving them the enjoyment of the worldly life. So when a person keeps on getting it and getting it and getting it, no hardships, no difficulties, doesn't remember his Rabb. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Hadid that don't be like those, فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Long periods of time went by, they did not remember their Rabb, they did not turn to their Rabb, so their hearts became too hard after that. And then, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ Majority of them became fasiqeen, which means involved in all, most of the major sins. And this is what we see. When people keep on getting the dunya, keep on getting it and getting it and getting it, they gradually start forgetting their Rabb. Imagine if for two or three generations they are very well to do, they are very wealthy. They get whatever they want. Children see the father was millionaire, the grandfather was same thing. So now, the ones that are there now and they are enjoying all of these things, how much possibility it is for them to be able to go to the masajid and turn to deen. It's really, as you look at the reality of their life and you look at the situation that is out there, very difficult. All the muharramat, they come into the house. All the haram things, they get into the house. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the doors of this dunya for people. But when he keeps on pulling the rope a little bit, and a hardship comes right there, you see everyone in the house is on musalla now. Now everyone wants to make dua. At the time of difficulty, people remember their Lord. But then, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran, there are people who remember their Rabb only at the time of hardship, and as soon as that difficulty is gone, they forget him again. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives an example in Quran al-Kareem. That people in the ship, in the middle of the ocean, they pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَنْ تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ When a difficulty comes to you in the middle of the ocean, you forget everyone else that you used to call beside Allah. فلما نجاكم الى البر اعرضتم. When he saves you and take you out to the land, then you turn away from him again. There's an example that when we are in the middle of the difficulty and we see no help can come from any side now, now the person is making dua to Allah, praying to Allah. I remember visiting so many people in the hospital. Make dua that Allah just gets me out of this situation. And you would see me in the masjid every day. I want to be, I'm narrating exact words. I want to be your student after I come out of the hospital. And maybe 5 years, 10 years, and not even one salam from those people. Forget about being a student. Not even one salah that you see the person in the masjid. فلما نجاكم الى البر اعرضتم. When you're in the middle of the ocean, you forget everyone else. You forget everything else. Person has a heart attack. He's in the hospital, please. He makes dua to Allah. Everyone make dua for me. Make dua for me. And now if Allah would save me, I feel so bad that I lost so much time of my life. If Allah gives me this life, a new life now, inshallah, I'll do this, I'll do this. As soon as he comes out, it's gone. These people are really ruining their akhirah. They promise Allah that, Ya Allah, if you do this for me, I will do this for you. Ya Allah, you save me from this, I would be praying every day in the masjid. Allah saves him, he runs away. And just as a reminder, so that we don't make this mistake, there are people who at a time when they are not having children, or some who don't have boys, and they make dua, Ya Allah, if you give me a boy, I will make him hafiz, I will make him this. After having a child, now they say, you know, okay, after a few years, let him just finish this and then we will do it and make him do it. And let him just do this and then he will do it. To the extent, some simple things people are not willing to do, and that is, very recently, someone called me. We said, if Allah will give us a boy, we'll name him this. But now the family is not accepting it, so can we just change the name? Subhanallah. Why did you promise Allah? And the effect of that, the reason I'm mentioning this, the effect of that is more than us that we have to pay in Akhirah is on our children's life. You broke Allah's promise about these children. You said, I will make him this, and you don't. That's it. They're out of your hands. That's it. They're gone. Now these children, instead of being rahmah and a mercy for you, and the coolness of your eyes, they become the azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the whole family. We cheated Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, we didn't cheat anyone other than ourselves. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also narrates in Quran that there are people who say, Ya Allah, if you give me wealth, if you give me good work, give me this. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ لَيْنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. They make promise to Allah. لَيْنْ أَعْتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. If you give me out of your bounty, I get a good job, I make good money, I get this. لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ. We will be giving a lot of charity. وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And we will become of the virtuous ones. فَلَمَّا أَتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوْا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. When he gives them out of his bounty, they hold it back. And they turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they don't even look back. تَوَلَّوْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. They turn away, don't even look back. As a result of that, فَعَقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ يَلْقَوْنَ. Allah puts hypocrisy in their heart until the day that they would meet Allah, which means pure iman will never come in their hearts. عَقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. He would put nifaq in their hearts till the day when they would see him. And they would see him with nifaq, not with pure iman. Very important reminders, very important things for us to remember. And this is why Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, malaika, the ones that were worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what they would say to Allah, Ya Allah, سبحانك ما كان ينبغي لنا أن نتخذ من دونك من أولياء. Allah will ask them, did you mislead them? Did you ask them to worship you? No, Ya Allah, impossible. We never did anything like this. But the fact is, ولكن متعتهم وآباءهم. You kept on giving them the enjoyment of the worldly life. حتى نسوا الذكر. Until they forgot the reminder. Forgot their book. Forgot your book. They forgot your deen, they forgot your prophet, they forgot you. Hatta nasu dhikr. They forgot the dhikr. And what does dhikr mean? Quran is dhikr. Remembrance of Allah is dhikr. Salah is dhikr. So following the deen in all different ways is dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hatta nasu dhikr. They forgot all of these reminders. They forgot the dhikr of Allah. They left away the Quran, they ignored the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they ignored Salah, they have no time for Salah, they don't have time for learning deen, for benefiting from deen, for even reading one hadith, no time for anything. حَتَّى نَسُوا الذِّكْرَ وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا بُورًا. And they were doomed. Bura has different meanings. One is halak, destruction. So therefore they were destroyed. Another meaning of bura is to be totally useless. And this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, إِنَّمَا النَّاسُ كَالْإِبْلِ الْمِئَةِ. The situation of people would become such, of the ummah would become such, كَالْإِبْلِ الْمِئَةِ. Like a person having 100 camels, لَا تَكَادُ تَجِدُ فِيهَا رَاحِلَةً. Not even one of them is good for ride. Someone has 100 cars, can't even carry the keys in his pocket. He has 100 cars. He wants to go somewhere, not a single one starts. What's the benefit of having 100 cars? Someone loves cars, he bought so many cars, he has 100 cars in his yard. Not a single one that is registered. He wants to go somewhere, he doesn't have a car. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this would become the situation of the ummah, that you would see 100 people, not even one that is willing to learn and practice deen. إِنَّمَا النَّاسُ كَالْإِبْلِ الْمِئَةِ لَا تَكَادُ تَجِدُ فِيهَا رَاحِلَةِ. Situation of the people would be like a person having 100 camels, not even one camel is good for rice. وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا بُورًا. They became useless people. This is the meaning. Now we can see, subhanAllah, you know, when you read the Quran, it seems Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just telling us about our situation. If we start counting the number of people, of Muslims in the world, or Muslims in the country, Muslims in the town, and if you need something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's difficult to get even one out of 100. It's a fact. And the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sure, we don't have to say, they are true word by word. So, فَكَانُوا قَوْمًا بُورًا. They were totally doomed people, or they were useless people. فَقَدْ كَذَّبُوكُمْ بِمَا تَقُولُونَ. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to these kuffar, that you heard what these people are saying about you? You worship them, and you claim that they wanted you to worship them, but you heard what they're saying. فَقَدْ كَذَّبُوكُمْ بِمَا تَقُولُونَ. They have made you liars about what you said and what you claimed. They clearly said it in front of you. You are standing here. You see them standing in front of you. And they are denying that they ever asked you to worship them. Why did you worship them? Where did you get that from? Amazing. If someone who is worshiping, for example, the sun. And you have people like that. In our time, we have people who are worshiping the sun. There are people who worship the moon. There are people who worship idols. If you ask them, who told you? Did the sun ever told you to worship him? Or he sent someone to you that you should worship me? Where did you get it from? Oh, because it shines so much? Is this the proof? Amazing. You know, where are you getting it from? This idol, did he ever told you that I'm your Rabb? Or did someone come to you and said that the idol talked to him and said that I should convey this message to you that he is your Rabb? If someone, believe me, if we would go today, we go to one of those people who worship idols, and you go and tell him, you put your ear by the idol, and then you tell him, this idol is telling me to tell you this. He will tell you you're lying. Why are you trying to fool around with? I know he can't speak. What else can he say? Is he going to say, okay, now you are the prophet on behalf of the idol to me? And this is exactly what happened at the story of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. He breaks the idol. They come to him. أَنْتَ فَعَلْتَ هَذَا بِآلِهَتِنَا يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ Did you do this to our idols, O Ibrahim? He says, بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ هَذَا Maybe the big one did it. فَسَأَلُوهُمْ إِنْ كَانُوا يَنْتِقُونَ Ask them if they can speak. فَرَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَنْفُسِهِمْ Now they go back, they talk to themselves. وَقَالُوا إِنَّكُمْ أَنْتُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ They're saying to each other, we are the wrongdoers. We are worshipping these idols who can't even speak. Now they turn to Ibrahim alayhi salam. ثُمَّ نُكِسُوا عَلَىٰ رُوسِهِمْ لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا هَؤُلَاءِ يَنْتَقُونَ Ibrahim, you know that they can't speak. Subhanallah. They admit, لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا هَؤُلَاءِ يَنْتَقُونَ You know they can't speak. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that where did you get this from that this idol is your Lord? That son is your Lord? Or the angel is your Lord? Or Isa alayhi salam is your Lord? Where did you get it from? فَقَدْ كَذَّبُوكُمْ بِمَا تَقُولُونَ They have denied everything that you say. In fact, they call you liars in what you have been claiming. فَمَا تَسْتَطِيعُونَ صَرْفًا وَلَا نُصْرًا But it's too late. Now you cannot turn away the punishment from your soul, neither you can receive any help. فَمَا تَسْتَطِيعُونَ صَرْفًا صَرَفَ يَصْرِفُ To turn something away. You can't even turn the adab from your soul. وَلَا نُصْرًا And you can't even get any help. If you at least had worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believed in Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. So, if azab is coming towards you, you can turn it away. If you are a true mu'min, then you may be able to turn the azab away from through some of your deeds. Your salah will help you. Your hajj will help you. Your charity will help you. But if you are not even that strong with your amal, at least you get nasra, which means help of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. You request the Prophet, please intercede on my behalf. You request, you had someone, houses in your family, you request them, please intercede on my behalf. So many people can intercede, but at least the mu'min can get some help. A mu'min can do two things at that time. He can turn the azab away through some of the a'mal. That is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a person recites Surah Al-Mulk every night. In another narration, Surah Sajda also, every night. These surahs will come in the form of a bird and will cover the whole person, will not allow the azab to get to the person. So, this is farfa, which means turning the azab away through some of your a'mal. Now a person didn't have any of these amal either.
So at least he can hope for nasra, help.
Help? I had a person, he was a good person, and I helped him. So he goes and looks for that person. Remember I helped you that day? Yes, I do remember. Can you now intercede on my behalf? Okay, let's go and talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This isn't a hadith, it will help him. Or, as I said, a son, that is hafiz. Son, I need you today. Okay, Dad, I'm ready. Or a person who had miscarriage. Children died in young age. A lot of different situations. A lot of different things can protect, can help at that time. And, of course, for us at least, we know Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is there for us. And he would intercede. And not only that, sometimes we feel on the day of Qiyamah, if a person has committed some major sins in his life, then he changed. So we keep on hearing that, you know, you did this type of sin, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will not be helping anyone with this. No. There is hadith, and this hadith is sahih. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, شَفَاعَتِي لِأَهْلِ الْكَبَائِرِ مِنْ أُمَّتِي. My intercession will be for those who have committed the major sins in my ummah. I will especially intercede on their behalf. Which means, a person committed major sins maybe long time in his life. He was in a different direction. Imagine, we have in the history so many of those, a robber. He robbed